inside this box contains
with incredibly sharp, tiny teeth. It causes earthquakes, and he is actually a jerk.
No? What, is that just me?
You mean to tell me that you have never stopped and truly tried to comprehend the magnitude that is catfish? Not just in the aquarium fish keeping hobby, but in the world. Seriously, no, it's still just me? Well, we need to talk about that. Did you realize that there are over 2,900 species of catfish on this planet? They inhabit literally everywhere from calm, stagnant waters and lakes to raging rapids and streams, and there's even a few species of marine catfish. That's right, there are saltwater catfish. Now, these catfish can range in size anywhere from just one single tiny little inch, like this twig, all the way up to, some reports say, 16 feet. From just about every corner of the globe, you can find a story of a larger-than-life catfish with a reputation as being a man-eater. A catfish that takes people that are swimming or off the shore and drags them below the surface of the water down to the murky depths so that they are never seen again. Pretty dramatic, huh? Even larger than giant man-eating catfish, in Japanese mythology, there is a giant catfish that lives in the mud under the islands of Japan called Namatsu. Now, Namatsu has to be physically pinned down and restrained by the god Kashima, and sometimes Kashima gets distracted and allows Namatsu to wiggle its tail. When Namatsu wiggles its tail, it causes earthquakes. And so when I actually sat down to make this video, I figured, Zach, the people want updates on all your fish. You should do an update on all your catfish. And so I actually counted out how many catfish I have. And the conclusion that I came up with is, I don't have nearly enough. I gotta bump up those numbers and buy another catfish. Inside this box contains something with a gigantic mouth, a true monster. Something that's always hungry, and something I've always wanted. But little disclaimer, there's actually two fish in this box, but you only get to see one of them today. Let's open it up. Now, before I actually show you what's inside the box, we're gonna do an update on all those catfish species that I just listed. I wanna show you some of my fish, we'll do some cool feedings and stuff, and then I'll show you the brand new monster catfish I got. But I just need to say that catfish hold a pretty special place in not just my hobby, but also on my person. I mean, I got one of my catfish actually tattooed on my leg. Boom! Channel catfish. Things are gonna be a little messy. You're gonna notice some things are out of place, but the way my fish room is laid out is I actually kind of have two different sections. So I have like the big section over here with a tank behind me you can't see yet, with my smallmouth bass. Most of my native species are actually in here, which I'm now realizing I kind of have like a native room and like a tropical room, so that's cool. But you can tell things are kind of a mess. There's a couch in the middle as I'm getting ready to like replace this rack, and then the filter is kind of torn apart. But so the first species of catfish I want to show you are actually my two different kinds of bullheads. So my first bullhead is actually in this tank with my massive smallmouth here, and you can see him kind of hiding out there, pardon the glare. In the dirty tank, this is kind of like a working fish room right now with all the changes I made, so you're gonna see a little algae. But so the first species is probably an 11, 12 inch yellow bullhead. Pretty much just hangs out underneath that log, underneath that rock there. Does not bother the smallmouth one bit, but actually cleans up a lot of the food that the smallmouth doesn't get. So they make good scavengers, which is kind of most catfish's MO. Second bullhead I have is way more active. This is a brown bullhead. This one was not wild caught. It was actually bought from my native fish supplier. He has actually blown up in size in here, and he is actually a jerk. Anytime I feed them, which you will see, the largemouth gets the bulk of the food, and the bullhead will try and take the food, not just out of the mouth, but he tries to get up underneath the gills as well. So this bullhead right here, awesome fish, love the color, love the activity levels and everything, but definitely needs to get out of this tank and into a bigger one, and needs to stop beating up on my largemouth. So back over to what I have just decided to deem like the tropical part of the fish room. This is actually where the bulk of my catfish live. This is a tank that you've probably seen like in the background of my videos, but I haven't really done like an update on or shown specifically because this tank's about to get some major changes. But let me show you this. So this tank right here is 125 gallons, but it's a little different dimensions. It's only 5 feet, so it's a little bit deeper, but it has three different species of catfish in it, including two of my really, really severely deformed tiger shovel nose. You can see that guy right there. They're doing great. His nose is just, yeah, slanted like that. So he's got a messed up nose, and then this guy has like a messed up back slash spine slash stomach, but they're both eating well, so I don't really think it bothers them, but they look a little funny. Then this catfish right here is my Lima shovel nose, so another species of shovel nose, but this guy actually only has one eye. You can kind of see the dent on the side closest to us, and then the bump on the side away from us. So there he goes. So the third species of catfish that I have in this tank is actually hiding up in that plant right there. Super shy, but he'll come out when we start feeding. I might have to turn off the lights to actually film him. But that is my black Walago catfish. And he came from Predatory Fins, the same place as this new kind of mystery catfish. But he is every bit of 16 inches with incredibly sharp, tiny teeth. And he has a huge appetite. And he's getting very big. So he's part of the reason that this tank is about to undergo some changes. So again, you can't see this tank right behind me just yet because it has a fish that nobody else on YouTube has, and I want to make like a separate video because it's crazy cool. But so this right here is my two 40 breeders. This is like a 40 breeder rack, and these tanks are actually about to move to right here. So I'll have my wipers and my walleye. The new catfish is actually already in that tank, and then a couch. So we'll get this kind of like peninsula and then some 40 breeder racks. But back to these tanks. These two tanks house actually probably my most unique catfish that I have in all of my tanks. So starting out with the first tank, the tank on top, kind of hiding out back in this cave. We'll see if we can get a decent shot of him. Pretty much all these catfish are going to be better filmed when I do like my feeding montage at the end. But this is my electric catfish. And this guy was tiny when I got him. Well, not tiny, but this guy was smaller when I got him. And he is an absolute cow right now. And I say that with like the utmost respect. So this tank down here on the bottom is actually home to my gulper catfish, who pretty much exclusively hides out back behind that plant, which makes him impossible to film unless he's eating. But this gulper catfish launched my YouTube channel. It was the first video that I posted. He only eats frozen thawed food like shrimp and tilapia, which makes him pretty unique. But I would argue he is one of, if not the largest gulper catfish on all of YouTube. He hasn't eaten in days in preparation for this feeding video coming up. And you can tell he is an absolute tank. So between that electric catfish, which can literally electrocute you, and the gulper catfish that can eat meals the same size as his body, I do have one more kind of catfish before I show you the new one. But don't judge this tank. It's super dirty. You're not gonna be able to see the fish. But this tank is like in the process of being torn down and moved. So if you've ever like messed with fish tanks, then you know sometimes you like just kind of let that tank sit as you're in the process of like opening up and moving new things. So I'll show you the fish just really fast, but the tank's messy. And so here those guys are. Tank is obviously dirty, like I said, but down here are two of my Asian red tails. I actually want to do like a full kind of spotlight on these fish as I move them to another tank. And you can tell we're being photobombed by the School of Oscars, but yeah, so once these guys get moved, I'll show you more about them, but these are my two Asian red tails, and they are getting huge. Again, they're gonna get their own tank and kind of moved up here, so we'll be able to kind of showcase them. But the fish that I got from Predatory Fins is like a dream catfish for me. I've seen them on YouTube before. They get huge, like 18 inches, and they have a gigantic mouth. Look at this guy. So that catfish is what's known as a jelly cat, a jelly catfish and a poor jelly catfish. This is a fish that gets giant. It gets like 18 inches, like I said, but that mouth is so big that you just literally can't keep them with other fish because they'll eat them. So he does not like to come out. Honestly, these catfish do not like the light. They need a place to hide, like a cave or underneath that driftwood. I set this tank up in a way that he has plenty of places to hide and kind of get away from me and away from the light. His light actually sits primarily over that Daphnia tank, which I just moved for like our benefit here. But here's a picture of what they look like when they're like full grown, because they are awesome. It's a catfish that I've wanted for a really long time. It's something I'm super excited to be able to grow it and share more videos on and tell you more about it. But most of these catfish, like I said, do not move until you introduce food. And you know, let's just do like a cool SC fish keeping feeding montage here. So enjoy the catfish and I'll be right back. So there you guys go. I told you they would be more active when I introduced food. Did I not? Hopefully you guys enjoyed this one. This is probably like the most real and like raw video I've made. You guys saw tanks with like algae and stuff like that, which I know. But that's just how it is, and you know, I'm moving things around, but I wanted to give you guys that update. You guys asked for the update. Let me know what you want to see the update on next. I could either do like an update on all my tropical fish. I could do all the native fish, do like all my bass. So let me know down in the comments what you want to see me do the update on next. I have a super cool video coming on that tank, which like I said has that unbelievable fish that nobody else has that was also in the box with the jelly catfish. So hopefully you guys are looking forward to that. Thank you again for watching this one. I hope you enjoyed, and until the next video, I will see you soon.
Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe. See you soon. See you soon. Hehehehe